Hi everybody, this is Byron Jacobs for EverymanChess.com making a short video about a new book in our Move by Move series. This book is on the Sicilian Taimanov and it's written by Grandmaster John Emms, who is a very well established and very highly acclaimed author and is also the commissioning editor for the Everyman Chess series. This book follows the typical structure of the move-by-move format, whereby the opening is discussed in some detail, but at many, many moments the reader is offered the opportunity to pause while looking at the analysis of the games and is asked a question and is encouraged to stop and think about what's going on in the position. You can also find another short video that describes the move-by-move series in more detail. The Sicilian Taimanov is a pretty dynamic approach to the Sicilian from Black, whereby its minor pieces are often developed very actively, and this can create many opportunities for active play in the middle game. The book is essentially written from Black's point of view, but of course players who play the open Sicilian as White will no doubt find much of interest for them to look at in there too. Now, I want to show you one short extract which exemplifies the kind of dynamic possibilities that Black has in the game, and also to ask a couple of the questions that John poses in the book. The extract we're going to look at arises after this opening sequence. Black plays, this is the typical Taimanov structure with the moves e6 and queen c7. White opts for one of the lines with bishop e2. And here Black exchanges off, develops his bishop with tempo, and the white queen retreats. Now, if we switch to the book, you'll see that at this point John has set an exercise asking how Black should continue development here. And the answer is, you may want to pause and think about this, but the answer to this is with the move b5. And as John points out in the book, there are many very good reasons to play this move. The bishop will be very active on b7, the pressure against the e4 pawn can be intensified by b4, and Black can plan to play rook c8, bringing the rook to the open c-file. So here play continues, White plays f4, bishop b7, bishop f3, and now we need to reach another interesting moment where the dynamic possibilities that are available to Black in this opening are revealed. And at this point, as you can see, John stops and asks you to think quite carefully about how Black can continue to develop his position here. And the answer revealed down the page is with the active move 12h5. And if we switch back to the board, we can play that move here. Now, the point of this move is obviously that Black has created an outpost for the knight on g4. And when the knight comes here, Black will develop very active possibilities to play on the king side. And I'd now like to show you one variation of a game that's given in the book that just shows how effectively this can work out. White continues his quiet development with bishop d2. The pawn comes down to h4, and now Black has created another possibility, which is knight h5 coming into g3 check with a big attack along the h-file. White drives the knight away, the knight comes in. It looks as if White has blocked off the danger with the knight coming into g3, but the knight comes in anyway. And after this sequence, we reach this position. Black intensifies the pressure with queen b6. And here White must be careful. If he continues with the logical move rook a to e1, then suddenly Black whips up a mating attack with the switchback queen d8, and now there's no defence because the rooks are bottled in the king. There's no defence to the attack along the h-file, a typical conclusion being with the familiar tactic like so. So White must prefer instead to play the move rook fe1 to create some room for his king, and then we get a very interesting forced sequence which goes as follows. Okay, so here black continues as follows by capturing on f3, and after g takes f3 he again plays the continuation queen d8, planning to come around to h4. Now the best move for white here is knight e4, which leads to complex play, which is nevertheless good for black, but if he snaps off the bishop, then black has a very nice combination with the rook sacrifice, the queen coming in. And now, although black is currently behind by a rook, a knight and a bishop, he gathers a whole load of material with the following sequence, and we're left with a rather unusual position, but one that's obviously winning for black. So hopefully that gives you a short flavour of the kind of material that's in our new book by Grandmaster John Emms, The Sicilian Taimanov Move by Move. This will be available in the US in June of 2012 and in the UK and Europe in April 2012. Thanks for listening. This has been Byron Jacobs for EverymanChess.com.